Now, without any further ado, let's get started with the popliteal fossa. So the location is behind the knee joint. It is a diamond-shaped fossa. And now let us talk about the boundaries. So all the boundaries are formed by muscles. So superomedially, we have semimembranosus and semitendinosus. Superolaterally, we have the biceps femoris. And then we have inferolaterally, the plantaris and the gastrocnemius lateral head. And then inframedially, we have the medial head of the gastrocnemius. Is that clear? Now, in structures forming the floor of the popliteal fossa, according to Datta, because there's a difference in BDC and Datta, we'll follow Datta now. Floor is formed above downwards by the popliteal surface of the femur and then the oblique popliteal ligament, posterior part of upper end of tibia, and finally fascia covering the popliteus muscle. Is that clear? Okay, then finally the floor is pierced by, we have middle genicular vessels, middle genicular nerve and genicular branch of the posterior division of obturator nerve. Genicular, all of them pierce the floor. And then roof is formed by popliteal fascia. And then roof is pierced by small saphenous vein and posterior femoral cutaneous nerve. And so we're talking about the contents. Okay, so we have these structures. And then talking about the contents, we have the popliteal artery, popliteal vein, the tibial nerve, common peroneal nerve, posterior cutaneous nerve of thigh is not that important. This is also not that important. Popliteal lymph nodes are a little important. And also a popliteal pad of fat. Is that clear? Now, let us get on to the popliteal artery. Before we get on to the popliteal artery, it is important to understand one diagram that will make stuff easy for us. So, we have structures in the order popliteal artery, popliteal vein, and popliteal nerve. Okay, so medial to lateral, in the upper part, this is the order, and then posterior to anterior, we have nerve, vein, and then artery, and then inferiorly from medial to lateral, this is the order. Clear? Okay. After that, let us get on to the popliteal artery. So popliteal artery is nothing but continuation of the femoral artery after it pierces the adductor hiatus. Okay. So at the junction of the middle one third and lower one third of the thigh, it runs downwards and slightly laterally reaches the lower border of the popliteus and then divides into the anterior and posterior tibial arteries. Okay. And then when we talk about the relations are very, very easy. So first, popliteal artery is the deepest structure in the popliteal fossa, yes or no? Because veins are superficial. And so anterior to the artery, or that is deep to the artery, we have structures which form the floor of the popliteal fossa, same to same. And then posteriorly, we have tibial nerve. Laterally, we have all these muscles which I mentioned earlier. We have the biceps femoris. And then we have lateral condyle of the femur in the upper part, plantaris and lateral head of gastrocnemius in the lower part. And on the medial side, we have these structures and also tibial nerve and popliteal vein in the lower part. Okay. And then when we talk about the branches, there are several muscular branches. So the upper two or three muscular branches, they supply the adductor magnus and the hamstrings, and they terminate with the fourth perforating artery. Cutaneous branches, they arise directly from the popliteal artery or indirectly from its muscular branches, okay? And then we have genicular branches, which are five in number. So one superior medial genicular artery, superior lateral genicular artery, which wind around the respective femoral condyles. And then we have a middle genicular artery, which pierces the oblique popliteal ligament. And we have inferior medial and inferior lateral genicular arteries, which wind around the corresponding tibial condyles. They take part in forming anastomosis around the knee. The clinical anatomy, one thing is we measure blood pressure through the popliteal artery in coarctation of the aorta. There is a lessening of the popliteal pressure when compared to brachial artery pressure. And then we have the fact that the popliteal artery is more prone to aneurysm than many other arteries. And lower part remains patent when the entire artery is affected, most of the artery is affected by atherosclerosis. And then popliteal vein, we have popliteus, and the vein begins at the lower border of the popliteus by union of other veins accompanying anterior and posterior tibial arteries. Okay, so the relations, I showed you this diagram, right, based on that, nothing else. And then it receives the small saphenous vein and also veins corresponding to branches of popliteal artery. Then when we talk about the tibial nerve, we have the root value, that is L4, L5, S1, S2, S3, all ventral. And then it is a larger terminal branch of the sciatic nerve. So it extends from the superior angle to the inferior angle of the popliteal fossa, crossing the popliteal vessels from lateral to medial side, artery, vein, nerve, okay? And then when we talk about the branches, we have superior medial genicular nerve, middle genicular nerve, and inferior medial genicular nerve. Superior medial, it kind of lies above the medial condyle of femur. So always remember, lies above the medial condyle of femur, and this extends onto the medial condyle of the tibia. And then middle genicular nerve, it pierces the floor of the popliteal fossa. And then the other branches include sural nerve, which is very important. It originates in the middle of the fossa. It supplies the skin on the lower half of the back of the leg, because popliteal fossa onto the back of the leg, and then also the lateral border of the foot. And muscular branches, they include, they supply the lateral and medial heads of the gastrocnemius, plantaris, soleus, etc. Okay, the nerve to the popliteus, in addition to popliteus, it also supplies the tibialis posterior, superior and inferior tibia fibular joints, and the intraosseous membrane, and also tibia. Okay, damage to the tibial nerve, what happens? Damage to the tibial nerve, it causes dorsiflexion, because tibial nerve supplies those muscles which cause plantar flexion. Okay, so common peroneal nerve, dorsal divisions of L4, L5, S1, S2. And then it is a smaller terminal branch of the sciatic nerve. It extends from superior angle to the lateral angle, and it winds around the posterior lateral aspect of neck of fibula. It is extremely important to mention that common peroneal nerve, it extends downwards from lateral angle of the fossa and winds around the posterior lateral aspect. Why? Because when there is injury to neck of the fibula, there is injury to the common peroneal nerve, and then there is foot drop. Okay, so the branches of this are sural communicating, and also lateral sural nerve. No need to mention lateral cutaneous nerve, of course. Lateral sural and sural communicating. The articular branches include superior lateral genicular nerve, inferior lateral genicular nerve, and recurrent genicular nerve. Okay, and then these two are not that important. And then we also have finally popliteal lymph nodes, which are 6 in number, and they lie deep to the deep fascia near the termination of the small saphenous vein. According to Datta, the location of some of these include the junction where popliteal vein is joined by the small saphenous vein, and on either side of the small popliteal vein, and like that. So they receive afferents from lateral part of the sole and both superficial and deep parts of back of leg and knee, and the efferents end in deep inguinal lymph nodes. Okay, so this is the applied aspects related to, these are the applied aspects. And then when we come to anastomosis around the knee joint, which is the last remaining topic, it is easy if we remember it in this way. That is, superomedially we have these, that is a branch of supramedial genicular artery with inframedial genicular artery, and then finally one descending genicular artery. Clear? Inframedially, again we have supramedial genicular artery, inframedial genicular artery, and saphenous artery. Superolaterally, we have supralateral genicular artery, infralateral genicular artery, and a descending branch from lateral circumflex femoral artery. And infralaterally, we have superior lateral genicular artery, infralateral genicular artery, and also branches from posterior circumflex fibular artery, because fibula is a lateral bone, and recurrent branches from anterior and posterior tibial arteries. Is that clear? And then finally, we have transverse anastomosis between superior medial and superior lateral, inferior medial and inferior lateral genicular arteries. And that's it.